Welcome. In this video, we are going to discuss about plaster mold casting process. Any casting process is called as a good casting process if it able to produce the components which are having intricate details and thin sections. In order to have this one, the molding material should have high fluidity so that it can take the shape of the pattern easily. For example, as water will take same shape as that of the container. If the container is round, it will take the round shape. If the container is square, it will take the square shape. The molding material should have high fluidity. The another requirement of the casting process is to get excellent surface finish on the casting. In order to get this one, the molding material which we are using, it should be made up of very fine particles so that the casting will get an excellent surface which we can avoid the secondary process. The another requirement of a good casting process is to have a high dimensional accuracy. For this, the molding material which we are using it should have a good grain strength and dry strength. Apart from this, it should not be get affected by the hot metal which has been poured into the mold cavity. In order to achieve all these requirements, we use plaster mold casting process. We try to understand the plaster mold casting process in detail. We use plaster of Paris or gypsum as a mold material. Normally, we use the slurry in order to get the mold cavity. Normally, the plaster is to be added to the water and not water to the plaster. And 100 parts of the plaster is taken and 160 part of the water is taken in order to prepare the slurry. You have to stir it continuously till you get a creamy consistency. Along with these two constituents, so we will put 20 to 30% of the talc and some amount of terra alba or magnesium oxide to reduce the initial setting time. Sometimes lime or cement is also added to control the expansion of plaster during caking. So in this way, the creamy consistency plaster slurry is being prepared and later it has to be poured into the cope and the drag. Normally we use metal castings in the plaster mold casting process. We avoid the wood plaster patterns as the moisture content in the slurry is absorbed by the patterns. Hence the metal patterns are used here. Cope and drag both are prepared simultaneously on different lines. Let's pour the slurry which has been prepared earlier into the cope. And a small vibration is given to the cope in order to get the initial setting of the plaster of Paris. Later, the cope and both drag are dried in the oven at a temperature of 200 degrees centigrade to 425 degrees centigrade. Then we will allow the cope and drag mold to dry it completely. Sometimes it may take up to 20 hours time to dry it. Later, we combine the cope and drag in order to get the required casting. So this is a simple detail about the plaster mold casting process. Let's try to look at what are the advantages of this process. The dimensional accuracy, we can achieve it up to 0.008 to 0.01 mm per minute, and we get excellent surface finish using this particular process. The thin section can be easily casted with plaster mold casting process. There are some limitations are there. The major limitation is that we should use this process only for the non-ferrous materials. If you use it for the ferrous materials, the sulfur which is present in the gypsum will interact with the ferrous material, which leads to the bad surfaces. the permeability of the plaster of Paris is low and the molds are very fragile in nature, we have to handle it very carefully. So, thank you for watching this particular video.